Today's topic is these road markings. Normally these road markings are very essential while we are traveling on these roads. Why? Because we need to observe what are the road boundaries, what is the central meridian of a particular road, so that we have to know those things while we are having different patterns on the road system. Otherwise we won't have to observe what is the particular end of your road, what is the meridian of your road, in what route we have to move, what is the edge conditions. All those things are known when the road having a proper marking system, so that we are having a definite marking system by some rules and principles. Why? Because in all over the India, that means we are traveling in all over India from one state to another state, having a connection with these national highways and other integrated road system, so that the road user has to face a unique identification system. Due to this unique identification system, there may be some control or less contacts with these accidents, so that we have to follow the total road marking systems all over the India as same as possible. Why? Because in a few of the states were having different languages and their different word pattern, so that all over we have to give a proper unique identification with the help of this English or any other Hindi system, so that those will be understandable to all the people, those who are transporting on the roads, means those who are having this driving field. So this road marking have some quite importance. First of all, we need to know these road markings are defined as lines, patterns, words or other devices, except signs. Without signs, although we are having these road markings like these lines and other systems, those are helpful to control. Means control means like a valve, they need to control the traffic regulations to some content by flowing mechanism. That means normally in few of the roads the vehicles are moving with a high speed. In expressways and national highways, likely we are having different flow patterns. In some of the ways, these are also useful for controlling the flow pattern of the vehicle. Next, these road markings will give a definite warning. That means you are going in a wrong way, so that you have to choose a proper way for your journey. Likely they will give a warning symbol. Next one, guiding. That means normally this guiding means we are starting our journey in a particular point, so that what is our destination point, means we have to choose our destination point, so that this guiding means after 130 kilometers there is a destination point. That means somewhat we have to go from Lucknow or Delhi, so that we are choosing these national highways, so that we have to know how many kilometers to our destination point by using these marking systems, which was filled by this National Highway Authority of India. Those directly give a guiding, that means in which this route we have to go, so that what is that is the distance between that point to that point. All those are guidelines to our journey. Next one, information. That means somewhat information. That means there is a long bridge, the span of the bridge is like this, and there is a course, there are speed breakers. Likely a small information while we are traveling on the road, those also fed by these road marking patterns and systems. What is the role of this road marking? Means guiding and controlling traffic. Simply they are regulating, simply that means the traffic flows and patterns, all those are telling and regulating. Next one, serves as a physiological barrier. Means they are simply give information as a bridge, so that we are simply moving from one part of the bridge to another part of the bridge. Likely by this information we are moving from our origin point to destination point, simply by usage of these studies and informations. Next one, that to delineation the traffic path, it is lateral clearance of traffic hazard. That means whenever there is some quantity of accidents occurred on a particular space, so that this information will protect us for a long period of that means protect us for saving our journey path. That means normally we are traveling on a particular road, so that in front of 2 kilometers there may be accident occurred. So that preliminary they will give a signboards and other things, so to evaluate and to divert the traffic, so that those also gives as a time free and we have to choose another path to our journey. Next one, to ensure the safe, smooth and harmonic traffic flow. All those are studied in previous class. This is the types of markings we are having: transverse marking, object markings and other markings. First means transverse markings, object markings and special markings. Traffic lanes. What is the transverse marking and object markings and special markings? Transverse means it is in the different direction. That means longitudinal markings we are having, it is also a straight lines, normally longitudinal means transverse means with respect to one direction. That means normally an inclined portion, inclined markings. Transverse means, transverse means with respect to origin, a somewhat angle to the x-axis and y-axis, so that these are called as a transverse marking. Normally these gridded lines and others are shown with these transverse marking systems. Next one, special markings means if there is any accidents or any other special informatory signs, those are used with these special markings. Those are normally not related to this traffic, but in rare extreme condition, that means in front of the particular road there is a some kind of hotels or any other, so that for the purpose of those they are using this special marking systems. It is a longitudinal marking, that means the lines are on the road as long as possible. That means those two are having a straight pattern without any angles, so that those are simply called it as a longitudinal. There is no angle with respect to horizontal plane, simply as straight as possible. Purpose of indicating this driver to his proper position on the roadway. That means the driver has to maintain his body in a constant, otherwise simply moving, those will cause a disturbance to the back vehicles. So that the driver has to move in a straight path whenever he was doing his journey on a road. It will be easier to the surrounding traffic conditions. Provide separate traffic flow on the same direction. That means it also provides some vehicular changes. That means if the vehicle is need to overtake, or a vehicle has to slow down, so that these conditions will useful for us for overtaking purpose also. That means straight lanes, the vehicle is simply traveling on a straight lane, means automatically the back vehicles will have to overtake by proper mechanism, by taking these side distances, overtaking side distances, so that these lanes will help us to overtake a vehicle very easily. Otherwise, if there is no signal system, there is no line system, means automatically the vehicular will, the driver will confuse us, so that there may be chance of skidding or accident purpose. These lines will delineate those accidents. After that, predominant color is used to white or yellow color. That means these white and yellow colors are normally more visible in nature after red, so that these are normally allocated on the roads depending upon the strata. That means if we are having a BT roads, normally on BT roads these white color and yellow color are more visible, so that these are employable on the particular roads. Otherwise for normal CC roads there is no color laying on the particular road. Why? Because the total surface is looking, and in some cases they will simply use these red colors and yellow colors on CC roads to know what are the edge points, what are the middle points, what are the central points and what are the cross sections. Definitely on those particular areas they will use these marking systems. Okay, we are having different proper lines, broken lines, solid lines and double solid lines. This is the things we discussed, these things we have to discuss in the yesterday's class. So today we have to continue this longitudinal marking. A central line, longitudinal marking normally having these central lines. That means central line is at a position at a particular center of the road. After that we are having these traffic lanes. Normally the road having n number of lanes depending upon the capacity of the road, so that each and every lane we have to mark with definite marking systems or painting systems. Next one, we are having no passage zone. That means no passage zone means if there is a some quantity of accident was occurred on a particular road, that means there is a more number of vehicles are clashed, so that at that particular point there may be no chance to go, so that they will definitely give a kind of information by choosing these warning lines. And no passing zone, that means the area is very danger, so that we won't have to go on that particular area simply by giving this no passing zone. After that, warning lines, that means war exceeding the road ends, so that these warning lines will be useful for us to overtake some content. Next one, border or edge lines. These border or edge lines normally we are having at the each side of the road, that means if it is a length on the particular central line, we are having around the central line, that means on the left hand side and right hand side, both sides we are having these edge lines. Next one, bicycle mark, bus lane markings and cycle markings. Normally at bus stands and other things we are having these markings for removal and means uplifting of passengers and delay of passengers. That means some of the passengers are simply choosing some places so that the government have approved some quantities of spaces for bus parkings and others. Normally APSRTC and other private traveling buses have chosen some points. At that particular points, we have the government has to give some quantity of space for these passengers purpose. That means simply passengers are lifting and downing the particular buses. Next one, central line marking. First of all, we are having this central line marking. What is the central line means? The central line separates the opposing stream of traffic. Opposing stream means one line is simply moving in the one direction, another line is moving in another direction, so that we need to separate those two streams of vehicles simply by giving this central line marking at the middle of the road, so that it will be easier for the drivers. It is a particular central line, so that we won't have to exceed the central line. If we exceed, opponent vehicle definitely clashes our vehicle, so that there may be chance of accident. So this central line will give a better idea to the driver to not exceeding the particular quantity of the road. Next one, usually no central line provided on the roads having width less than 5 meters and 3.5 meters. That means a single lane roads and other roads, normally in residential areas we are having this kind of roads, so that in residential areas we won't observe this central line. Why? Because the length of the road is so small. These are the central marking systems for two lane road. Here we are having a long width line, after that we are having some quantity of breakage, after that normally we are having length breakage. Likely this central line marking having this kind of pattern, and those markings also we are having some quantity of dimensions. For length of the quantity is 3 meters, width is 150 meters or 160 meters, so 160 centimeters. After that, it is a two lane traffic. That means two lane means normally we are having central lane, after central lane there is two lanes. That means two lanes are for both streams of vehicles. One is up going stream, one is coming stream. In the going stream we are having two quantities of lanes, in coming stream also we are having two quantities of lanes. Those two lines and two lanes are dividing with this central line, those also having dimensions here. If there is more than two traffic lanes on each side of the road, what we have to do means we need to construct a long thick line. That means this long thick line will help us to a more bifurcating of those two roads. After the bifurcation line, we are having three lanes on each side of the road. Okay, in the left side we are having three lanes, in the right side also we are having three lanes. It is a normal four lane road. That means on only single direction we are having four lane roads without any bifurcation line. That means centrally we are having this central line without any long bifurcation line, we are having some short bifurcation line. This is also having dimensional quantities, 3.3 meters, 150 meters likely. Here there is a two lane road on each sides. That means left hand side we are having two lane road, right hand side we are having two lane road with the proper marking system, a subdivisions and divisions. If there is any increase in capacity of the particular road, so that we have to use some quantity of different signs. Why? Because there is more quantity of traffic, so that they need some huge amount of these markings for observation purpose. At intersections, traffic lines, lines will have eliminate these confusion facilities. That means there may be huge quantity of roads are joining at a particular point, so that there may be some quantity of confusion or illusion, so that due to those also there may be some accidents taking. So that we need to eliminate those kind of accidents taking, we have to use some quantity of more line by simply increasing the capacity of the road, and we need to give some more quantity of safety features on the roads. This is the better example for what is a no passing zone. Here we are having a horizontal curve. In this particular horizontal curve, whenever there is a long length of the vehicle is simply moving, due to the movement of the long length of the vehicle, the radius will not be sufficient for over, that means simply moving purpose. For that we have to give some quantity of extra space. Those spaces we are call it as a widening of the roads. Particularly whenever we are having these radial roads, automatically in that particular radial roads we are having some quantity more than the required. That means normally for a single lane we are having a 3.5 meters length of the road. In case of this radial road, we have to exist for 4 to 5 meters depending upon the normal daily flow of vehicle capacity. The daily flow of the vehicles are normally restricted to two small vehicles, automatically we have to give a 4 meters. If there is any movement of long line vehicles, we have to give a 5 to 6 meters width of the road. Depending upon the survey and the data, we have to construct the road and we need to give a proper lining system. No passing zones are established on summit curves, horizontal curves and two lane or three lane highway roads. That means in this particular horizontal curve we are having a center line, so that those kind of zones we are call it as a no passing zones. Why? Because in this particular point we are having a huge quantity of vehicles are simply moving with high speeds. Okay, there are also having some quantity of super elevation and drainage, so that it is a strictly area, so that all the vehicles has to move with high speeds without some quantity of lacking of these side distances due to this radial curves, so that there may be strict provision of no passing zones. Summit curve, horizontal curve and three lane roads, overtaking exercises are prohibited. That means in this particular zones there may be no chance to overtake. If we overtake, definitely we have to give some quantity of burden to the others. That means simply we are overtaking means the besides vehicle have to face some quantity of burden. So that whenever we are traveling on this kind of horizontal or vertical inclination of the roads, we need to take some quantities of precautions. Simply we have to observe, if there is no vehicle in front of us, in back of us, definitely in that conditions also we have to overtake. Otherwise we don't have to do those kind of blunder things. It is also a one kind of no passage zone. Here we are having completely U-turn, that means the total road in the shape of U-shape. So that in these places also we are having a blind side distances, so that the opponent vehicle with what speed it is coming, those things we don't have to observe. Why? Because it is a U-turn like things, so that we need to go in very specified manner. That means whatever the speed they prescribed, with those speeds only we have to move, and in these conditions we won't have to take these overtakings. Why? Because it is a no passing zone, so that no passage of one vehicle is takes place. That means simply we have to move in a single line only, we don't have to change that route to another route. Next, it is a warning zone.
What is the warning zone? What is the warning zone? Means normally warning lines are warns the drivers about construction obstruction approach. Normally what is obstruction means if there is any other important of the road, that means any other importance of the place is there, automatically we have to give some quantity of warning lines. In front of the particular length there is a some quantity of statue or any other is there, so that you need to slow down your speed. Likely in front of a particular road there may be a horizontal curve of this length, so that we have to decrease the speed or you need to take some quantity of additional precautions. Those things are normally comes under these warning lines. They are marked on horizontal and vertical curves. Why? Because in this particular horizontal and vertical curves we have to take a much quantity of precautions. Those are broken lines with 6 meter length and 3 meters gaps are constructed. Normally these kind of roads we will observe in hilly areas. Why? Because most of these horizontal curves and vertical curves are faced in hilly regions. Why? Because there may be some huge quantities of hills are there, so that we don't have to dredge those hills and we have to construct a straight lines. It is a time consuming processing and money consuming process, so that simply we are constructing these horizontal and vertical lines in hilly areas. At these particular spaces we are decreasing our money by constructing a vertical loads or horizontal loads, so that those money we have to spend on these warning lines and other maintenance to prevent the accidents. A minimum 7 line segments should be provided. That means the total line will have a width of 6 meters length and 3 meters gap, and the total length will be, the total lines will be in 7 or any other, minimum is 7 line system will be here. Next one, what is the edge line? Edge line means normally at the end of the particular road we have to face these edge lines. In airports and other areas we have to observe these edge lines. Why? Because normally whenever the airports are landing on the highway, the roads, it means roads which are located in these airports, the pilot has to observe what is the road end, what is the road meridian, all those things he has to observe. After the observation is over, he need to simply land the flight. Otherwise the flight has to be land in other normal roads. That will be cause a more dangerous, sometimes a blastings also in the aeroplane, so that he has to observe with a clear cut manner in a proper way by these radials, that means edge lines and center lines, so that national highways and other things we are having these radium stickers on the particular road, so that they will give a proper information, that is the proper end of the road, that is the meridian of the road. Due to lack of light in the night system, in the night time, we are having some delineation in our observance, so that these radium stickers will help us for identification of the edges of the roads and central lines of the roads. Normally they should have to at least 150 mm, that means 15 centimeters from the actual edge of the pavement. They are painted in yellow or white line. Normally we are observing these red colored radium lights in night system. Why? Because red and white systems we are using, some quantity of yellow symbols also, those three are we are using, so that they will give a better understanding what is the particular edge of the road, what is the particular central line of the road. They will paint it on the yellow or white lines. Normally at the line should have a preferably light reflective, so that they will give visible during the night also. That is the point. That means in the night time normally some of the paints will not absorb, so that these radium paints will have a better observance phenomena, so that those are really useful for us in the night time. Improved night visibility may also obtained by the use of minimum glass beads. That means glass beads means a proper breeds of these glass. That means normally in metals we are having some quantities of alloys, likely in the glass also there is some quantities of breeds, so that they will some quantity of bead, that means a minimum amount of thickness. That means top plate, in the top side we are having some plate, bottom side we are having some plate, in the middle of the particular those beads we are having some quantities of lines, so that they will have a better appearance phenomena, so that these glass beads are embedded in the pavements at particularly from a particular thickness, so that this will help us for giving this knowledge on the pavements, and they give produce a reflective observance and surface. What are the transverse markings? Normally, transverse means normally are marked across the direction of the traffic. They are marked at intersections, etc. The type of road marking for perpendicular intersection depends upon the several variables such as speed, traffic, availability of space. Normally, transverse, that means we are having a directions. Transverse means it is a some quantity of angle, so that these transverse markings are marked across the direction of the traffic. What is the direction of the traffic means? If there is any movement of traffic on a particular lane through, so that along the particular lane we have to give some quantity of marking. It will be useful for the road users, so that these transverse markings are marked along the transverse lines which are having a particular road. They are marked in intersections, comma, and other places also. Intersections means normally there may be combination of 2 to 3 roads. In this particular spaces we have to give these markings, otherwise they will confuse what is the particular merging of the road, what is the minimum distance from the particular cross section. All those things will be better when we are having these marking systems on the road. Otherwise there may be some stopping delays and sighting delays. If there is a better markings, automatically there may be better control of our vehicle. The type of road markings for a particular intersection depends upon several variables. Means variables means different things are associated with these road markings. Why? Because in the road we are having a huge amount of speed and different types of vehicles and different tire qualities we are using, so that there may be different variables are associated with these road parameters. In this, what we are having is first one, speed characteristics of the traffic. That means speed means for different kinds of vehicles we are having different speed limits and speed restrictions, so that we have to give some quantities of these marking systems, comma, availability of space. For some kinds of roads we are having less quantity because of surrounding situations. The surroundings we are having likely temples or any other statues or residential houses, so that we won't have to extend our road. In those particular conditions we have to give a better appearance. Next one, stop line markings, comma, markings for pedestrian crossings, comma, we have to give a proper directions. This is the stop lines normally. This is the stop lines normally what we are having. In this particular stop lines we have to stop our vehicles. Why? Because of in the opposite opponent direction there is another stream of vehicular flow, so that we have to stop our vehicles, and there may be some quantities of signal light systems. By observing those signal light systems, red lights and green lights, we have to continue our flow. Vehicle should not proceed when the required stop by control device like signals and other traffic policies. That means a manual or vehicle, that means computer operated systems are there, so that by using those we have to continue our rides. They shall place it either parallel or intersecting roadway at right angles to the directions. That means parallel or intersection. It means normally parallel means those two road lines without having any intersection. Those are called as a parallel lines. Intersection means there may be some quantities of angles. If there is a 90 degrees or 60 degrees or 30 degrees, depending upon the road joining. So that we have to control those by using different line marking mechanisms. That means signal or line marking mechanisms. Next one, what pedestrian crossings we are having? That means pedestrians means normally those who are walking on the roads. Those are called as the pedestrians. For those purpose also we are having some quantities of roads and markings are located. Why? Because those are also one of the part of this transportation mechanism, so that we have to give some preference for the pedestrians also, so that in some conflict places, that means these conflict places are normally observed whenever there are a crossings. In that particular crossings we are having these conflict places, so that those are having some quantities of importance. Between vehicle and pedestrian traffic is severe. That means there may be some huge quantity of vehicular flow and less quantities of these pedestrians, automatically there may be damage. So that all the vehicles are moving with high speeds, so that there may be chance of clashing with these pedestrians. So we have to give some more extra time. Next one, the site should be selected that there are less inconvenience to the pedestrians. Also, the vehicles not interrupted too much. That means whenever we are taking a proper place for this pedestrian walking purpose, those place will not have any effect with these vehicles. That means in some of the places vehicles has to stop a sudden. That means suddenly the vehicles are stopping. Due to those also, pedestrians has to face some quantities of interruptions and uncomfortable things. So that we need to avoid those by choosing a proper place for the pedestrians, so that will definitely give a accident-free areas for the moving of pedestrians. This is the normal signal at the signal systems how pedestrian roads, that means pedestrian crossings, are designed. This is a four-lane road. Means in the particular four-lane system, we are having a zebra crossings with high thickness. That means high width and normal lengths we are having, so that these will help the pedestrians to move on those lines without interrupting a traffic. Whenever there is a red symbol or green symbol or amber symbols, in those particular symbols, they need to continue their walking to cross the particular roads. At intersections, they may be proceed by a stop line at a distance of 2 to 3 meters on signalized intersections, and there may be interruption of distance of 1 meter for signalized intersections. Most commonly used pattern is a zebra crossing consisting of equally spaced wide strips with 500 mm wide. Normally, at these particular pedestrian crossings, we are having a pedestrian flow of 1.2 meters per second. That means for each second, the pedestrians has to move with a speed of 1.2 meters, so that they will have to move likely. Otherwise, the time will be less contributed to the pedestrians. In this particular zebra crossings also, we are having a crossing system with proper markings. Those markings also we are having a dimensions. The dimensions are normally 2 to 3 meters for unchannelized intersections. What are channelized and unchannelized means? Channelized means simply there is a proper marking system. That means if there is a two-lane road, normally those two-lane roads were observed with this central line and edge lines. If all the central lines and edge lines are there, automatically it is a channelized road. That means channels are made with the help of this marking system, so that those are called as a channelized roads. In different areas, we are not having these six systems. That means say these paintings and other, those roads are called unchannelized roads. That means there is no proper markings on the edges of the roads and the central line of the roads. Those kind of roads are called unchannelized roads, so that we have to differentiate those kinds of roads. If there is a channelized roads, automatically we have this zebra crossings and others. In unchannelized road, we have to choose a proper place nearer to the particular junction, and we need to continue our walking. Most commonly used pattern is a zebra crossing. That means zebra crossing, it is very much superior to everyone. Why? Because most of the years we are following these zebra crossings for crossing the roads, so that it is more and well known thing for each and every pedestrians. Next one, what are the directional arrows we are having? This is the proper directional arrows we are observing in the national highways and other horizontal or vertical curves. Normally, horizontal curves or vertical curves, we need to divert our direction of journey due to these curves. Likely, these arrows are useful for us to make our journey as free as possible. These direction arrows are having some quantities of dimensions. That means for every arrow, we need to use proper quantity of dimension. What is the arrow head? What is the inclination of the arrow head? What is the width of the arrow head? What is the tail part of the particular arrow? What is the minimum thickness at the entrance and exit points, so that we will have a better communication in each and every highway or any other things they have to follow these patterns only. Should use it to guide the drivers advance over the correct lane to be taken while approaching busy intersections. That means intersections means normally a combination of 2 to 3 roads. In particular, those intersections we have to move in a right path by observing these arrow paths. That means normally we are going on a single lane road. So suddenly the single road is converted into 3-lane road. Automatically those 3 lanes are diverting into 3 other routes. We need to continue our route by observing proper these arrow directions. These arrow directions will takes in our right route. Otherwise, if we follow an uneven pattern, automatically we will diverted our route. We have to take a more amount of journey, and that may be a time taking process, so that these directional arrows will give a direction in what way we have to move, what is our destination points. All those arrows should be elongated in the direction of traffic. Adequate visibility. Adequate visibility means some quantities of adequate space is there, so that in that particular spaces these adequate visibility conditions are there, so that these arrows are normally used on the purpose of continue our duty. The dimensions of the arrows are very important. Why? Because if we are simply constructing a small arrow that is not visible to the driver, there is no use of particular arrow. So that it should be visible to each and every driver, so that we need to give a proper dimensions. Those dimensions are very much important. Why? Because by the dimensions only the users will have to observe. They will take a survey on which dimensions is very much superior to each and everyone. Why? Because in the roads itself we are having different mindsets of the people are simply going. For those different kinds of mindsets people, they are having different blindness properties. That means some of the persons having this eyesight and other parameters in their mindset, so that we need to give some quantity of a proper length, width and thickness. Those will be very much useful for us. Normally arrowhead is, height of the arrowhead is 1.2 meters. After that we are having a width of 0.5 meters below the arrowhead. The total length of the arrowhead is 3.5 meters. 3.5 meters, 1.2 means simply the remaining part is 2.3 meters. Likely we have to denote. If it is any diversional arrow, that means diversional arrow means the one road is simply moving on one direction. It is a one direction road and the road is diverting into another route also. So that in these particular cases we have to choose these kind of diversional arrows. In this diversional arrow also we are having same features, but at the middle point we are having another arrow with different specifications. That means 0.5 and 0.5 simply we are having one, simply it is a 1 meter length. We are having 0.2 meters of width of the particular small arrow. What are the object markings? Object marking means normally if there is an intersection of the road, due to those intersections we have to construct a large quantities of pillars in the middle portion of the road, so that the users have to understand what is the pillar and what is its dimension, in what way we have to move, so that those things will be given by using this marking system. That means normally in metropolitan cities we are observing this kind of intersection of the roads. That means one lane of the road is laid on another lane of the road with a proper UC flows and under channel, underground channelized flows and other flows we are having these roads, so that at those particular combination of the roads we are having these objective markings. These objective markings are normally useful when there is a construction on the roads itself. That means normally we are having a different drainage purpose also, and a different kinds of purposes we are constructing a small quantities of structures, likely these greeneries and others we are maintaining on a particular roads. So that we have to show those by these marking systems, simply object marking systems. Here we are having a physical obstruction. That means physical means it is a not moving one, it is a constant one. So that we will call it as a physical obstruction. Those are so that we have to use a
different marking systems for these physical obstructions. Physical obstructions in carriage way like traffic islands. Normally traffic islands means if there is a 4-lane road or 3-lane road, we are having a rotaries or any other traffic islands. So that for those also we have to use these object markings. In front of us there is a rotary island, in front of us there is a long column, in front of us there is a short carriage way. So that all those things we have to use, that means all those things we have to denote with these object markings. Traffic islands, obstructions near carriage way like signal post, pyres, that means pyre means normally a column, pyre columns. So that if you won't give a proper object marking, there may be leads to a severe damages and accidents to the road users. This may be marked on the objects adjacent to the carriage way. That means if there is any proper carriage ways and other things, that means normally we are having these carriage walls and other shear walls. That means shear walls are there on the particular roads. That means national highways, we are having these shear walls, so that around the shear wall and total periphery of the shear wall, we have to give some quantity of marking so that it will be visible to us. Normally, in a recently, few of the cities having unrest, that means few of the cities having these shear walls, so that they simply painting different kinds of images, likely these elephant symbols and peacock symbols and other religious symbols on these carriageways and other shear walls, so that it will be a better visible phenomena, as well as there may be some quantity of education we are directly giving. In front of us there is a some quantity of picture, so that there may be some obstruction, we need to go in definite way. Likely we have to give a different markings for a better understandable to the road users. Objects, what are the objects within the carriageway normally we are having? The obstruction within the carriageway such as traffic islands. Normally we discussed what are the traffic island means. Those are located at the different location. That means whenever there are a intersection of 4 to 5 roads, we have to maintain these traffic islands. And next one, raised medians. That means the raised medians we have to give if the length of the road is so long, that width of the road is so long. Likely we have to give different objective markings for those, definitely extremely for these traffic islands and raised medians. Why? Because these traffic islands and raised medians are mostly we are observing on the roads, so that we have to give a high priority to those. After that, the stripes should have a forward and angle of 45 degrees with respect to direction of the traffic. That means those lines will have a direction of 45 degrees. We need to continue.